हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू ऑल हियर मी?
ओके सो इन लास्ट आवर वी हैड कंप्लीटेड दिस थिंग. ओके सो नाउ दिस टॉपिक ऑफ टॉपलिंग एज वेल एज दिस बैंकिंग ऑफ रोड्स इज कंप्लीटेड. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज सेंटर ऑफ मास. ओके सो विल स्टार्ट विद दिस सेंटर ऑफ मास. एंड इन सेंटर ऑफ मास एक्चुअली द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम सेंटर ऑफ मास ओनली फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ मास इज नॉट आस्क्ड. जनरली दीज क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम सेंटर ऑफ मास विल बी रिलेटेड विद द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया. सो व्हाट द क्वेश्चंस यू वुड बी सीइंग that there will be a system whose center of mass will be given to you and then the system will be changed. Either some mass will be removed or some mass will be added. All these things will be done to that. And then probably you will be asked to calculate the center of mass, moment of inertia for the new body or the new system. So for that, you should be able to calculate the new center of mass of the body and then you should be able to calculate the moment of inertia and then do the things. So before going into moment of inertia, we have to see what is center of mass. Okay. So as I told you, like for this alone rotation chapter, each topic I'll take 15-20 minutes as a theory and then we'll do the questions. Okay. So center of mass is not a very difficult topic. Okay. So we'll start with few results, direct results, and anything that is required to be explained in detail, I'll take that. Otherwise, we'll do very quick. Okay. So first thing is center of mass for a two-body system. So just all of you, if you can recall the formula for the center of mass of the two-body, write down in the chat. By the time I'll draw the figure for that. Okay. So you have two bodies of mass M1 and M2. Okay. M1 and M2. The length is L. The length is L. And assuming that M1 is greater than M2. Okay. So direct result, if you remember for this thing, then it will be better for us, you, that this point will be center of mass. Actually, this should be closer to M1. They should be closer to M1 as M1 is greater than M2. So if this length is R1 and this length is R2, okay. So what I can write for R1 is R1 is equals to M2L by M1 plus M2. Okay. This is a direct result. And in terms of R2, okay, in the terms of R2, if we take, so what I can do? M1L, M1 plus M2. So these are the direct results that you should know for center of mass. Okay. Center of mass of a two-body system, okay? Suppose I'm taking an example here, or you people solve for this. This is 6 kg block, and this is 9 kg block, okay? And this distance is 4 meter. Now tell me what is the distance of center of mass from 9 kg. I want everybody to reply for this. You have a formula in front of you. I want at least 5 to 6 answers for this. Yes. This is 6 kg. This is 9 kg. I want the answer. Okay. From 9 kg. From 9 kg, what will be the center of mass? from 9 kg, what will be the center of mass? From 9 kg, what will be the center of mass? I got three answers. Okay, 1.6, 2.4, 8.5, 2.4. Yeah, correct. So from 9 kg, see here, if I'm taking from 9 kg, so what I have to do? I have to take the other mass. So other mass will be 6, the distance between the two bodies, and then divided by the sum of the masses. So it becomes what? If I cancel with 3, so this will be 5. 3 twos are, so it will be 8 by 5. And you solve this, you'll get the answer. So it will be 1.6. Okay, so 24 by 5, 24 by 15, 8 by 5, 2.4, 2.4. How 2.4 you got? I got two answers as 2.4. No, 2.4 will not be the answer. 24 by 15 will be the right answer. And this is a location. This is the location. So that's why it should be in meters. Okay. This should be in meters because this is mass and this is also mass. So mass and mass will get, this unit will get cancelled. So this has to be in meters. So this was all about the two center of mass for the two body system. Now, the next is, and one more thing, that this center of mass for the two body system is a very important result. Though it looks very simple, but very complicated problems can be solved using this concept. Okay, very complicated problems can be solved using this thing. So this is not a very simple formula. Don't understand that questions will not be asked on this. You can, what you can do, you can simplify so many questions that are like subtractive mass, additive mass on a two body system, and you can solve the question very easily. Okay, now the second kind of thing in this is center of mass of a multi particle system. Okay, multi particle system. So for a multi particle system, suppose you have this. Two, three particles are there. One, two, three. Suppose one particle, second particle, third particle are there. Now, what generally will be given to you? The position vectors of all the three. The position vectors of all the three will be given to you. And now you will be asked to calculate the center of mass. So let us assume this is the center of mass and this is having r. Okay, position vector r. This is r2. This is r3. And this is R1. Okay, now either you say in terms of XYZ or you say in terms of position vector, anything can be asked to you in the exam. Okay, either they can ask you the X coordinate. Okay, they can ask you the X coordinate. They can ask you Y coordinate of center of mass. They can ask you Y coordinate of the center of mass. They can also ask you the Z coordinate of the center of mass. Okay, so everything is important. Now, the values I'm not writing here. Okay, any book you will refer, you'll get the values. Okay, how do you give that for X? For X only I'm writing. It will be like M1, X1 plus M2, X2, and like that, so on, divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3, like that. It will carry on. Okay. Like that, you have to write for Y also and Z also. Like that, you have to write. One more thing in this, you have to see that is center of mass, the position vector of center of mass. So, how to write the position vector of the center of mass? It will be like M1 R1 vector, where R1 vector is the position vector of the first particle plus M2 into R2 vector. Plus M3 into R3 position vector divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3. Okay, now there are two things in this, that when you write like this, okay, when you write the center of mass in this way, okay, so in this way you are writing the coordinates, okay, x, y, z. It will be the these will be the coordinates, okay, these are the coordinates, but this is what? This is position vector. This is position vector. Okay. This is position vector. And what are these? What are these? These are coordinates. These are coordinates. So just try to understand there is a difference between this approach and this approach. One gives you the position vector. And one will give you the coordinates of the system. So with this, okay, the next thing is the next thing will be your mass moment. Okay, the third thing that is important will be mass moment. Okay, mass moment. Mass moment. Now this is also very very important. This is also very very important. Okay, you can solve so many questions. So after this first thing, okay, this is very important. So I'm marking it as 5-star. This is again also very important. So this is also very important. So this mass moment, okay, is a vector quantity basically. This is a vector quantity. This is a vector quantity. This is vector quantity. Okay. Now, actually, try to understand what is this mass moment. Suppose, okay, first, what I'll do, I'll write the definition for this or the statement for this, and then you will understand in a better way. So, what I can say for this mass moment. About center of mass, okay, sum of mass moment, sum of mass moment of all particle, okay, is always zero, is always zero. So what is actually written here? It is saying that about center of mass, sum of mass moments of all particle is zero. Now try to understand what is this actually mass moment. Okay, so all of you just I'll ask you people to just read this statement. Okay, just read this statement, whatever it is written in front of you. Okay. Okay, now see here. Suppose I have a particle of m1 mass here and I have a particle of m2 mass here. Okay, now this is a line joining. This is the line joining to them. And if I say, assume that here is the center of mass, here is my center of mass. This is the center of mass, location of the center of mass. So now, suppose this distance is x, this distance is y. Okay. So mass moment, if I am saying mass moment about center of mass, so mass moment about center of mass for m1, I will write as this. Okay. Mass moment of center of mass of m2, I will write as this. Okay. Their sum is zero. Their sum is zero. That means if I have two mass system and they are kept away like on both the sides, so I can equate them, then only their summation will be zero. Then only their summation will be zero. So this is the way how you can solve these questions. Okay, so in you'll understand in a better way when I when we take questions on this. Okay, we'll solve the question on this, but try to understand the theory first, that about center of mass sum of all the mass moments of a particle is always zero. Okay, and then you can find out center of mass, the location of the point. I can find out as this mass moment, or this is the position vector actually, and mi, where I will be 0 to n. Okay, I'm removing from here. So this is mass moment. Okay, now this same concept, the moment, the mass moment concept, I'm going to use and solve a very simple problem in a subtractive body. Okay, center of mass of a subtractive body. I'll make use of the mass moment. Okay, so next thing is, okay, next thing what we have is, center of mass of a center of mass of subtractive body. So what you have to do in the subtractive body, just see that. So subtractive body means you will be given with the body. Okay, in J mains or in NEET, the questions from 1, 2 and 3, the heading, whatever numbers I have put, this 1, 2 and 3, the direct question does not comes from these three. But you will have a question from this, okay, center of mass of a subtractive body. You will have a question from this, okay? You may have a question from this. So just focus on this thing. This is an important concept. So center of mass of a subtractive body. Now let us assume that here I am having a disk. Okay, this is a disk. Now for this disk, okay, has some mass M. Okay, this disk is having a mass capital M. So I'm writing it here. Mass of disk is capital M. Its radius is capital R. Now, what actually we are doing, you are removing a small mass in this. Okay. Now, actually, initially, this was the center. But what you have done, you have removed this mass. So now what I can say, the mass that has been removed has this center. Okay. So this is O. Okay. This is O. This has become O dash. Okay. The center of mass, okay, now shifts towards this point. Okay. The center of mass has shifted to this C point. So let us assume it has shifted to x distance. Now just to see the situation here, all of you, just I'm leaving this for a few seconds on the screen. Just try to understand the situation. I had a disk of mass capital M. Okay. A small portion, a small disk out of it has been removed. Okay. So now what I can assume is that this disk is having mass M1. Remaining part is having mass M2. Okay. Initially, the disk was having capital M mass. The radius was R. The disk that has been removed, this small part, okay, this distance, okay, this distance is R by 2. This is R by 2. Okay. So R by 2 disk has been taken out. Now you have to calculate the value of x. Now you have to calculate the value of x. So I'll just give you 30 seconds for all of you. Just tell me, okay, just tell me that what is the distance, what is x value, what is the value of x here, what is the value of x here? Yes, what is the value of x here? I want everyone to reply, all those who can answer this. Just 30 seconds you take and try to answer this question. Value of x. Yes, I'm still waiting. Value of x. I got one answer. M1r. No. Value of x. Value of x. Can you calculate the relation between M1 and M2? Can you calculate the relation between M1 and M2? The mass that has been removed. Okay. The mass that has been removed. Okay. You can assume, if nothing is given to you in the question, you can always assume that the mass is uniformly distributed. Always you can assume that the mass is uniformly distributed and try to solve that using that concept. Yes, still I am waiting for the answer. These questions you would have solved. These questions you people would have solved. Okay, let us see how you will solve this. Once again, I am asking you people that anybody is having, okay, r by 2. No, no, no. Not r by 2. Once again, I'm asking you that, did you understand the situation? There was a disk of mass M. Okay. A small part of, from that disk, a smaller disk has been taken out, and it is given in the figure how it has been taken out. Now the M1 mass has been removed. So the remaining mass is M2. The remaining mass is M2. R by 16. No. No, no, not r by 16. Let us see what, how we will do. Let us see. Okay. See here. Actually, what we have to do here. So assuming that the, now see here. All the answers I have got, 4-5 answers, all are wrong. Okay. Unfortunately. Let us see how we will solve this. Assuming that the mass is distributed uniformly. Okay. So what assumption I am making here? I'm assuming. Assuming that mass is distributed uniformly. This is what I'm assuming here. So when I assume this, okay, so what I can say that M1 will be directly proportional. Okay. M1 will be directly proportional to the area. Okay. Surface area of the smaller disk. Okay. Now, if I remove this proportionality sign, okay, so listen here. One thing I want to make clear, one point, that generally what we have tendency that this is a very silly mistake that generally we people do, that whenever we remove this proportionality sign, we forget to put a constant. Okay, we forget to put the constant. Though here in this question, if you put also or if you don't put, the result is not going to matter. Okay, it is not going to affect your result. But always in such questions, try to or make a habit like always to put this constant, proportionality constant. Okay, so mind it. Okay, be careful about this point. So this proportionality sign, if I remove and I will put area, so it will be what? Pi r square. So what is r here now? R by 2. So it becomes r square by 4. So this is m1. So this much mass I have removed actually. Okay. So this is area and this c is a constant here. Okay. Similarly, if I calculate for m2, if I calculate for m2 mass, so for m2 mass also I can write c pi. Okay. What I can write? Initial area minus final area that has been removed. The part that has been removed like this. I'll be able to write it like this. Now, when you write it like this, okay. So can I say M2 will be actually 3/4 or like this I'm trying to write C pi r square by 4. And this is nothing but m2 is equals to 3. Suppose this value I am taking as, what shall we take? M0. Okay. I am taking this as m0, this complete thing. So can I write it as 3m0? Just see here. See this thing. Just let me know if anybody is having doubt in this here. Anybody is having doubt in this? Yes. So now I have found out two things. One, send this mass of this bigger disk, mass of this smaller disk. And now I'm assuming that the center of mass is here. Now simply I can, what I can do, I can apply the mass moment relation and I can write m0 into r by 2, okay, will be equal to, I can write it as 3m0 into x, okay, 3m0 into x I will write, correct. This is what I will write. And now you calculate x value, it will become r by 6. So this is the answer. So this x value becomes r by 6. Do you understand it? Yes. Now the similar questions can be framed in a different way. Instead of disk, I can have a square. Instead of disk, I may have a square now. I can give you square. Okay. I can give you square. I can cut circular part out of it. I can have a square. I can cut a rhombus out of it. Okay. So all these things, just be confident that you can calculate these things now. Okay. Subtractive mass. Okay. Subtractive mass. Now let us take this thing a little bit on a higher level. This was for the two D diagram, okay, 2D figures. This disk, square plate, all these were 2D figures. Now, suppose there is a sphere, what you will do? In case of sphere, suppose you have a sphere and R by 2 sphere has been cut out. Okay, the same figure I can copy. I can copy the same figure. Okay. Yeah. Same thing. Just this is a sphere now. So what will be M1 now? Again, you will make the same assumption and you can write M1 will be what? C 4/3 pi r by 2 cube. Okay. Now, because here mass will be directly proportional to the volume, okay, there mass was directly proportional to the area, here mass will be directly proportional to the volume. So mass will be directly proportional to the volume here for 3D bodies. So this will be m1. M2, how you will calculate? So initial, what was the initial? 4 by 3 pi r cube minus 4 by 3 pi r cube by 8. Okay, so this you calculate. Okay, I'm leaving this as an exercise for you to find out the m2 value. Suppose this is m0, I'm assuming. Okay, so just calculate m2 here, and same thing what you have done here. Okay, what you have done here using mass moment concept of mass moment, using the concept of mass moment. Okay, you can solve it. So is this clear now? The center of mass of the subtractive bodies, how you will calculate. Okay, this is the way how you can calculate. Understood? Now, in this, one small topic more is there, like that only. Okay, like there is a subtractive mass, so I'm removing something out of a given body. Next I can do is I can add anything on this. So what the next thing we can do in this is that center of mass of additive body. Okay, center of mass of additive body. So in additive body, suppose what we have, this is a body. Okay, this is its center. Now assuming that this is a uniform body, okay, so mass is uniformly distributed, its center of mass lies at its geometrical center, this body has mass capital M. Okay, and now what you do now on its circumference or anywhere you just place a mass small m. So now if I place a mass like this, okay, so what I can do that now I have to calculate the center of mass for the system. I have to calculate the center of mass, the location of center of mass for this system. So now can you see here, if you see this, so I can say that at this O point, the complete capital M is concentrated. Okay, so this figure I can draw like this. This is a point mass of capital M mass. This is the small m mass kept, and the distance between them is x. Here in this case, x value is r. Okay, so now in this case, if I want to find out the center of mass, so what I can do, it will be small m capital R divided by capital M plus small m. So this is the location of center of mass. Suppose this is at this point. Okay, so this is C. So OC length will be this. Suppose if you want to calculate from the other side, so it will be capital M into R divided by capital M plus small m. This will be the thing. When one extra mass is kept on the body. Now suppose if I keep two mass, okay? Similarly, if I keep two mass, so what I can do? One more mass I'm placing here in between, somewhere in between. So let us assume this distance was y. Okay, so first what you can do? You can calculate for this system. So two body system you have calculated. Now this two body you assume as one. This two body you assume as one. So this point, okay, this point will have a mass of capital M plus small m, and this will be its location. And then you can solve for these two things, okay? So like that you can do center of mass of the additive bodies. So this was one thing, okay? Now in the continuity only, okay, one more topic is there, one more point is there, that center of mass of a flat geometrical figures, okay? So after this point, this is the last thing, and tomorrow probably we'll start with the questions of this, okay? So the last point is center of mass of flat geometrical figures. Flat geometrical figures. Okay. So you will be very comfortable, most of you, in calculating the center of mass of these bodies. I'll give you some dimensions. Suppose this is A, this is 2A, this is 2A, this side is 3A, this is A, and this is some 2A, 2A, and A, 5A. Okay, like this. So now I will ask you to calculate the center of mass of this body. So you can easily calculate. Suppose if I give you a system now, somewhat like this, okay? Somewhat like this. And if I tell you that this is 5A, this is 3A, and this is A. Now calculate the center of mass of this body. Okay. So you are, most of you will be very comfortable in calculating the center of masses of these bodies. Okay. So with this, almost the theory portion we have covered. Okay. Now what you will be doing, I'm giving you one small question. Just try to solve it. Okay. Suppose there is a mass. Okay. There are two mass system. One mass is kept at origin. Okay. One mass is kept here. There are two masses. This mass is 2 kg. Okay. This one is 4,3. This is at 4,3. And this is some 4 kg. This is any 4 kg. Now you have to find the location of center of mass. You have to find out the location, means coordinate I'm asking. Okay. I'm asking you the coordinates of center of mass. So I'm writing it here. You are required to calculate the coordinates of center of mass. You are required to calculate the coordinates of the center of mass. Okay. Yes. You are required to calculate the coordinates of the center of mass for the given figure. I need the answers for this. Okay. One of you have already given the answer, Harshada. 8/3,2. Correct. 8/3,2 is the correct answer. Anybody else who has got the same answer? Anybody else who has got the answer? Anybody else who has got the answer? Yes? Anyone else who has got the answer? Okay, one person also has got the same answer. Okay, all those who have not got the answer, just see here. I'm solving this. Here, actually, this is a 4 kg block and this is a 2 kg block. Okay, this is a 4 kg block and this is the 2 kg block. then what I can say that this point should be the center of mass. This point should be the center of mass. Okay, fine. Now, if this is the center of mass for this body, okay, if this is the center of mass for this body, so what I can write here is, just see, I am asking you the coordinates. So x is center of mass, what I will write? M1, its x coordinate, plus M2, its x coordinate, divided by the summation of the masses. Okay, so if you see here, so first mass I'm assuming as 2 kg, so 2 into 0 plus 2 into 0 plus M2 is 4 kg and its x axis is 4, so 4 into 4 divided by 6. Okay, so when you solve it, you will get 8 by 6, it will become, sorry, 16 by 6, so it will become 8 by 3. So location of x coordinate for the center of mass is 8 by 3. Similarly, for y, you have to find. For y, what you can do? For y, I will write m1, y coordinate of the first mass, m2, y coordinate of the second mass, and then summation of the masses, like that. Okay, so 2, y coordinate is 0, plus 4, y coordinate is 3 here, divided by 6. So now this will become 12 by 6, and this is equals to 2. So the location of center of mass is 8 by 3, comma 2. So this is the answer, okay? This is the answer for this part. Now, next question you just take, okay? Next question. Suppose, second question number 2. You have 1, 2, 3. Okay. So this block is like this. Then from here, you can draw the figure with me. Okay, it is like this. The figure is given as like this. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, so these are 8 blocks given to you. Now in this question, what is given to us is that block 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, block 1, 2, 3 and 4, and then we have a, these all are of mass is small m, these all are of mass is small m. Then you have a block 5, 6, 7 and 8, these all are of the mass 2m. Okay, these all are of mass 2m. Now you have to calculate the center of mass for the system. You are required to calculate the center of mass for the system. So I'll just give you the hints. Afterwards, you can solve. Okay. So if this is the system that is given to you, so to solve this question, okay, you can take the blocks of the same mass, okay, as one. So now I am taking this complete thing as one. I'm taking this complete thing as one. 1, 2, 3, 4 as one. Okay. I'm taking 5, 6, 7 as 1. I'm taking 5, 6, 7 as 1 and then 8 as individual. Okay. So I'm actually what I'm doing, I'm adding all of them together. So here if you see, so the center of mass for 1, 2, 3 and 4 may combinedly lie at this point. At this point. Okay. Somewhere here. Okay. Here. And height will be somewhat like this. Okay. For 5, 6, 7 and 5, 6, 7, the center of mass will lie somewhere. And for 8, it may lie somewhere here. Like this. So now you can draw a figure. Okay. Like this. 1. Then you may have 2. And then you may have 3. Okay. Assuming that all are square of side A. Side A. Okay. Side A. All are square. All are square. Okay. So this will be of mass 4m. This will be of mass 6m. This will be of mass 2m. Okay. Now, what will be the location? What will be their location? Okay. So for this, if you see, it will be A, this distance plus this distance, 2A along X, and height will be A by 2. For this 6M, what you have to write? This is A and this is half A. So it will be 3A by 2, comma. What will be the height? 3A by 2, if you say. Okay. For this, this will be A by 2. X value will be A by 2. And height will be A plus half A. So it will be 5A by 2. Okay. So now you have three particles of mass 4M, 6M and 2M. Their X coordinate and Y coordinates are given in front of you. And then you can calculate this value. Okay. So tomorrow when we start, we'll start from this numerical only. All of you are supposed to calculate the X and Y, this X and Y coordinate of the center of mass, and we'll start from this. Okay. So tomorrow we'll see in detail some problems that has velocity of the center of mass, acceleration of the center of mass, forces of the center of mass, and how this projectile motion and explosion cases are clubbed with the center of mass. So tomorrow we'll take some very good problems on center of mass. Okay. Thank you.